Life can be stormy. Life can be difficult. We can become fearful. Pastor KJ is about to preach a message about how to keep our eyes on Christ, that Christ's Spirit will steady us. So stay tuned for that message. But first, let's begin with our new artist in residence at First Plymouth, Justin Payne, as he sings a beautiful old standard. Let's worship.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my precious Lord, and lead me home. My way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near when my life is all. I fall, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the night draws near and the
We have a beautiful bronze statue of Jesus at First Plymouth at the moment that he's walking on water. Let's go to Matthew chapter 14. Immediately, Jesus made the disciples get into a boat and go on ahead to the other side. After a while, he dismissed the disciples and crowds, and he went up a mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But about that same time, the boat was being battered by waves, and it was far from the land, for the wind was against them. And early that morning, when it was still dark, Jesus came walking towards them on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the water, they were terrified. They thought, "Is it a ghost?" And they cried out in fear. But immediately, Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter answered him, "Lord, if it's you, command me to come out onto the water." So Jesus said, "Come." And Peter got out of the boat and started walking on the water and came towards Jesus. But right then, he noticed the strong wind. He became frightened and he began to sink. He cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him and said to him, "Oh, ye of little faith, why did you begin to doubt?" When they got into the boat, the wind ceased. And those in the boat began to worship with Christ and saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." What an amazing reading.
You just listened to Justin Payne sing, "Precious Lord, Take My Hand." As many hymns go, it was written during a time of tragedy by Thomas Andrew Dorsey. It was when his wife, who was pregnant with his son, died at childbirth. And he went into a room and wrote that hymn, and he said the words felt like they came straight from God. Dorsey was born in 1899 in Georgia, and he lived for 94 years into 1993. His father was a Baptist minister, and his mother was a music teacher. He was known as the father of black gospel music, transforming traditional hymns written by Tinley and others to blues and jazz. This worldly combination was not well accepted, but at first, because it was gospel, but now is fully adopted. The hymn could have been written for our passage today from Matthew 14. "Precious Lord, take my hand. Lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the night. Lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home." And so let's dig into this scripture today, because what we find is Peter reaching out his hand to Christ in this. First of all, this verse happens right after Jesus has fed 5,000, and he sends the disciples ahead in the boat. And they were out a ways, and he had gone to pray, and he decided to join them, and he walks on the water. And what happens that we see shortly as dawn, as he went out there, the disciples saw him on the lake, and they were terrified, and they said, "It's a ghost," and they cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, don't be afraid." In this verse, we find three times that Jesus says immediately. So Peter, brazen Peter, he kind of challenges Jesus. He said, "Lord, if it's you, tell me to come and walk on the water." Kind of a sarcasm a little bit there. And Jesus says, "Come." So then Peter got down out of the boat and he started to walk on the water. But when he saw the wind, okay, first of all, we don't see the wind, we feel the wind. But when he felt the wind, he was afraid and began to sink and cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, there's our second immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith, why do you doubt?" And when they climbed back into that boat, the wind died down. Think about that. When Jesus was present, the wind went away. Right now, in this summertime, the wind is our grace. If it wasn't for the wind, the high humidity, the high heat would be miserable. So I don't know about you, but I enjoy the wind right now. However, there's that moment in time when the wind comes in a storm. And it's that eerie feeling when it all gets dark and the wind is blowing and the trees are kind of going in a circle, that we begin to be afraid of the storm. Well, the Bible has 231 passages about the wind, and each and every one of them has a lesson for us, and each and every one of them is a story. So why do we doubt? And I guess my question for you today is, what is your wind? What is the wind that takes you off track? It is easy to let the stormy winds of life upheave our faith. Yet it is in the midst of those crashing waves, it's in the midst of the storms of life, the toughest times in life, that we need to turn towards Christ, that we need to reach out our hand in prayer and ask God to be there with us. And sometimes we get off track. We obsess over all the problems and we don't take them to Christ. If we remember what happened when Christ did step into the boat, the wind calmed. And when we reach out to God for help, things seem better and they start to get better. Every storm has its time and its lifetime, but then it passes and then we can move on. Another beloved hymn that First Plymouth uses a lot, and you usually hear it with the Plymouth Brass, is Just a Closer Walk with Thee. And the refrain in that goes, just a closer walk with Thee, grant it, Jesus, is my plea. Daily walking close to Thee, let it be. Dear Lord, let it be. There's one more secular song that I want you to plant in your mind as a reminder of the scripture and a reminder that you're never alone. And that is from the 1945 Rodger and Hammerstein musical Carousel. And it is the song, You'll Never Walk Alone. Most of us who have listened to musicals know that song. And the song was written again in the turmoil of life. We have two characters that fall in love, they get married, and shortly after they're married, they find out they're unemployed. Then she's pregnant, the husband's freaking out, and so he goes to a desperate move to try to get money. And when he does, he falls and he ends up dying on his own knife. At that moment in time of that tragedy, the song, You Will Never Walk Alone, is sang to her. But as all musicals and stories lines go, there's an ending where he gets to come back 15 years later and see his daughter graduate and make peace and forgiveness with his wife. You'll Never Walk Alone is a comfort for her, and it is a comfort for us. When you walk through the storms of life, and we each have those storms of life, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. Don't be afraid of the wind, whatever comes. And at the end of the storm, there's a golden sky and the sweet silver song of a lark. And at the end of our life, and at the end of each storm that we go through, Christ is there. He is always there with us. Many know You'll Never Walk Alone from this musical. However, it has been adopted worldwide sometimes as a national anthem when there's times of tragedy. And the songs, you know, goes, walk on through the rain, through the dreams. Though your dreams be tossed and blown, things don't always go the way we want them to. Walk on with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. You'll never walk alone. Christ is our hope. We will never walk alone because we have him walking right beside us. So live your life, get through the storms, keep going no matter what, and persevere and run the race of life.
Thank you.
As you go into this holiday week, remember that Christ is with you. Through the storms, no matter what the wind blows your way, Christ is always with you. Go with love, go with peace, and share that with one another.